If you ever wanted to know what would happen when Source Code and Nonstop have a baby, you now have your answer.
I will find you.
The Commuter stars Liam Neeson, Vera Farmiga, and Patrick Wilson, and is directed by the same director who made Unknown, Nonstop, and Run All Night, also starring Liam Neeson. Liam Neeson stars as Michael McCauley, a former cop and current insurance salesman who meets a mysterious stranger played by Farmiga, who offers him $100,000 to find a passenger on the train, and things escalate from there. The movie works more as a mystery slash thriller than an over-the-top action movie, but it does have its moments. As mysteries go, it does work fine, it keeps you invested. The movie gives Liam Neeson enough reason to want to take on this job and find the passenger. It sets up the situation by showing a group of passengers and trying to figure out which one of these is the right one. As opposed to a movie like Source Code, where you're trying to figure out who the villain is, this one does have a slight twist on who the passenger is. It's not technically the bad guy. One of the passengers is a banker slash rich guy, and he could just be called that, just the rich guy. Pretty much every one of his lines is about money. Why'd you bump into me? Do you even know how much this suit costs? You want me to keep the phone down? Your perfume costs a dollar. Oh, you want me to hire you, Liam Neeson? You couldn't afford me. So not all of the characters have the most depth, but there are some interesting back and forth between some of the other passengers. Though most of the movie is somewhat stale and somewhat forgettable, there are a few good scenes in the movie. For instance, in the beginning, it could have been out of a completely different movie. It could have been out of like a family drama. There's this great montage showing his sort of day-to-day routine and his daily life. When the action scenes do start, there's some great popcorn moments and over-the-top action, though there's some highly improbable things that happen, but they're forgivable. In the end, it is slightly forgettable, but if you like Liam Neeson or action movies, you're probably going to enjoy it. I'd probably give it something like 2.5 out of 5 stars. Thanks for watching, be sure to check out the rest of my reviews and some more random videos, and I'll see you guys next time.